Well, I'm telling you, this press junket is amazing. We are keeping it rolling, and I got a special guest with me today, Miss Tamrin, who also has ties to the Seattle area and is in this show. I can't wait to dive in. Hi, Tamrin.
Hello. So nice to meet you.
You as well. Well, first things first here, we got to talk about your ties to Seattle.
Let's talk about Seattle.
Yeah, and what it means to be in a show coming here, knowing that you have such a great connection to the city already.
Totally. I mean, I've been buzzing for weeks just in anticipation of coming back home. It feels so good to be here. I've been thinking about it for so long, and to come back to my hometown where I grew up, where I fell in love with dance, where I fell in love with the arts, where I took my first acting classes, feels like 100 years ago, to actually come back to Seattle and feel the energy of the city, it's amazing. I'm so thrilled.
You know, one of the things that I think is so clever about any show is that it takes everybody, whether it is set design, costumes, music, it takes everybody that's on that stage. Mm-hmm. Tell us a bit about what you bring to this show, Tam.
Yes, so I'm a swing in this show, which means I cover basically the entire ensemble. The heels ensemble. So I cover 6 ensemble dance tracks, and then I cover Le Chocolat. So at any moment's notice, I just have to be ready to jump up and do it.
Wow. You know, that's a lot of preparation.
Yeah.
And I'm so glad I'm able to talk to you about this, because oftentimes I don't get to talk to one of the swing cast mm-hmm. members. That's so huge, because you have to do a lot of study to be ready at a moment's notice. Tell us a bit about that for you and how it's kind of shaped up during this show for Moulin Rouge.
Yeah, well, this is my first time being a swing. So I had a lot of fear coming into it. And I was actually cast in this production a week before the COVID shutdown. So I had 2 years of stress dreams about being a swing in Moulin Rouge the musical. But the moment that rehearsal started, I felt so much support and so much care from our choreography team in particular, and showed up and was able to do the work. And also our entire company of offstage performers, offstage because we're on stage all the time, there are 9 of us who are not scheduled to be on stage every night. Mm-hmm. That company of people, one of the most kind, talented, dedicated, voracious group of people that I've ever met. And everyone cares so much, and everyone is so humble. And that goes for the onstage company too, because we show up and we have different bodies than the people that they're used to partnering with, and they embrace us with open arms, and we embrace them right back. Oh. And hopefully no one falls on the ground.
Yeah, I love hearing that. And I'm almost always mentioning how every cast for me, when I was fully in theater, we created a sense of family, right? Like from all of the folks that are never seen, that are behind the stage, that are in the lighting booth, that are manning, you know, audio, like, there's always this sense of like family, because you pour so much into any one production, and it's like everybody's giving their all, and you see it, you know, through everyone. So I love hearing you say that.
Oh, totally.
Also, when we think about representation in theater, you know, us being on that stage means something to somebody who's in the audience that is now seeing you on stage and seeing themselves be able to do it at this professional level. Tell us about how that's resonated with you over the course of your career in theater.
That it's such a great question. It's something that's on my mind so much. I grew up in the ballet world, and I have so much love and I have so much respect for the ballet world and for the incredible things that ballet dancers do. So I'll start there.
Yeah.
I was never going to be a ballet dancer. I didn't fit the mold. And the mold I can say with some hope, with some optimism, is maybe shifting.
Yeah.
But we always have these insecurities about our bodies, especially as a Black woman, you know. And I grew up hearing like you have to dress in a certain way because people are going to look at you in a certain way, and you have to present yourself in a certain way, and you have to have a little extra care, a little extra caution. And as a dancer, it's a tricky thing, because you want to be able to be out there, you want to be able to be free, but you also have to be a bit guarded. And then you bring in you know, everything that we deal with our bodies and growing up and your body is changing and you're like, oh my God, I don't know how to be in the world and things are a little lumpier than they used to be. Yeah. And what does that mean for me? What does that mean for my career? And I am so lucky to have landed in this moment with this company of people who look so different from one another. This is probably the most diverse cast that I've been a part of, even within our Heels ensemble. Everyone looks so different, and everyone does this choreography with their own unique style. No two people in our show dance the same. No two people in our show look the same. And that makes it so much, for me, so much more appealing. It makes it feel so much, it's so accessible, it's so inspiring to be a part of and to be able to be embraced with my body the way it is and seeing everyone else's bodies. I mean, it makes me emotional. I'm so lucky. I feel so grateful. And I hope that young women, I hope that everyone who comes to see this show is inspired by what they see up on that stage.
I'm going to tell you right now, I'm super inspired by your answer and the passion behind it because it's so real. And that for me is something that I'm always looking for when I come to any live show. Mm-hmm. How can I connect with those folks on the stage? That is such a major part of how audiences experience live performance, yes. Right? It's this energy exchange every time. And so I want to ask you a bit about that. How have you been experiencing the response from the audience in terms of, you know, what y'all are pouring out there? Are they receiving it?
Oh,
are
my
they
gosh.
Loving it?
I will say Seattle has been one of our best audiences so far. It is, maybe I'm biased, but I feel the energy from everyone here. And our show, it's full of songs that you know. So people can sing along. You know, don't sing too loud. I don't know if the people in front of you would want to hear that. But feel the energy. Give it back to us. Like, this is a show. It almost feels like call and response sometimes. You know, it's amazing.
Well,
it's
that's incredible. Really unique too. In the theater world, because oftentimes it's so specific to the show. So I love hearing that. When you think about a couple of things that you really want folks to walk away with in terms of y'all putting it all out there on the stage for everyone every night, what are some of those main points you want to make sure the audience feels and walks away with when they come to Moulin Rouge?
Such a great question. A feeling of hope. A feeling of the importance of love, of passion, of art. How lucky are we to be able to make art right now, especially after what we just went through with the pandemic? We're back. This was my first show back on stage, to be able to perform in a theater full of 3,000 people, all breathing in a room together. it's something to not be taken for granted. So I hope that people feel the energy. I hope people feel the good energy that we're putting out, the loving energy that we're putting out, and are able to take that into their holiday seasons and into the new year.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, my goodness, Tamrin, you get to look right there, and you tell people, come and see this show in that camera right there. Make sure they hear from you why they need to be here.
Come see Moulin Rouge. Experience the spectacular. Experience the love. Experience the joy, the dancing, the costumes, the lighting, the set. Come for the elephant. Enjoy the show.